हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ कोमल चौहान, एमएससी नर्सिंग ट्यूटर एट दिनसा पटेल कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग इन मेडिकल सर्जिकल नर्सिंग डिपार्टमेंट. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूरिन फॉर्मेशन एंड द यूरेटर. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद द यूरिन फॉर्मेशन. सो किडनी इज द एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन ऑफ द बॉडी विच रिमूव्स द वेस्ट फ्रॉम द बॉडी एंड इट फॉर्म्स द यूरिन. सो यूरिन फॉर्मेशन टेक प्लेस मेनली इन थ्री स्टेप, दैट आर द ग्लोमेरुलर फिल्ट्रेशन, ट्यूब्युलर रीअब्सॉर्प्शन एंड ट्यूब्युलर सिक्रेशन. सो किडनी हैज द मिलियंस ऑफ नेफ्रॉन्स विच एक्ट एज द फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द किडनी एंड विच प्रोड्यूस द यूरिन एंड फिल्टर द ब्लड. ओके, सो फर्स्ट पार्ट इज द ग्लोमेरुलर फिल्ट्रेशन. So in nephron, there will be a afferent arterioles which carries the blood from the body and it divides into the branches that is called as a glomerulus, and their filtration take place between the glomerulus and the Bowman's capsule or the glomeruli capsule. The epithelial cell of the glomerulus and the podocyte of the glomerular capsule creates the semi-permeability which allows the blood to be filtered out, and it allows only small molecule to be filtered. So small molecules like some water molecules, then some hormone create uric acid, urea. This small molecule will only the filter out from the blood, and the large molecules like the plasma protein and the blood cells will not filtered by the glomerulus. So there will be only filtration of the small molecules of the blood. So which fluid we get into the Bowman's capsule, it is called as the filtrate. Okay, so this is about the first step of the urine formation, that is the glomerular filtration. So water and solutes smaller than the proteins are forced through the capillary walls and pores of the glomerular capsule in the renal tubules. The second step is the tubular reabsorption. Okay, so whatever filtrate we have got into the tubules, it will reabsorbed by the tubules, so it is called as a tubular reabsorption. The molecules or the substance which are needed for the body, which should not be excreted by the urine, it will be reabsorbed by the tubules into the peritubular capillaries. Okay, so water, glucose, amino acid and the needed ions are transported out of the filtrate into the tubule cells and then enter the capillary of the blood. Okay, so efferent arterioles which has the filtered blood will pass and divides into the branches that is called as a peritubular capillary, because it surrounds the tubules. Okay, so whatever filtrate we have got into the tubules, it will reabsorb the needed substance for the body, and that substance or molecules will be returned by the peritubular capillaries. So it is about the tubular reabsorption. Then next is the tubular secretion. Okay, so hydrogen, potassium create and drugs are removed from the peritubular blood and secreted by the tubule cells into the filtrate. So as I have discussed, the efferent arteriole divides into the several branches that is called as a peritubular capillaries. That is the filtered blood, but it has some ions which should be excreted by the blood, which is harmful to the body. Some drugs and some create and other molecules should be excreted by the body, and also the hydrogen. Okay, so it is the mainly needed for the maintenance of the blood pH of the body. So here it can be removed from the blood, and it helps to maintain the blood pH. So it is about the tubular secretion. Okay, so in the body there will be about in 1 minute there will be a filtration of blood about 120 ml per minute. So it and the filtration which takes place into the 1 minute into the glomerulus is called as a glomerular filtration rate. Okay, so this is about the urine formation, which has to be take place in 3 steps, that are the glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption and tubular secretion. So next we will see the ureters. Okay, so ureters are the pair of muscular tubes which carries the urine from the renal pelvis to the urinary bladder. Okay, so whatever urine collection is present in the into the renal pelvis from the major calyx or from the minor calyx, it will be collected into the renal pelvis and it will be carried by the pair of organs or pair of muscular tubules, that is called as the ureter, to the urinary bladder. Okay, so ureters are extended from renal pelvis to the bladder. And if we talk about the size of the ureter, then ureter is about 25 to 30 centimeter long, and the upper half of the ureter lies into the abdominal cavity and lower half into the pelvic cavity. Okay, so renal pelvis continues as the ureter and it pass downwards to the abdominal cavity behind the peritoneum cavity, and it pass obliquely to into the it pass into the pelvic cavity obliquely into the urinary bladder. Okay, so it is the reason why there is a prevention of the backflow from urinary bladder to the ureter. So it measures about 3 mm in the diameter, but it's slightly constricted at the 3 place. Okay, so diameter of the ureter is about 3 mm, but it is constricted at the 3 place. Those are the at the pelvic ureteric junction, at the brim of the lesser pelvis, and its passage to the bladder wall. At these 3 places are constricted places of the ureter. Then histology of the ureter. So histology of the ureter, there are the 3 layers, that those are the mucosa, muscularis and the adventitia. Okay, so inner layer, the muscula composed of the transitional epithelium, and the middle muscularis is divided into the consist of the smooth muscle, that those are the inner longitudinal layer and the outer longitudinal layer, and the outermost layer is the connective tissue which continue as the renal capsule. And the ureter is supplied by the branch of the arteries. Those are the renal artery, abdominal aorta, gonadal artery, common iliac artery, internal iliac artery and inferior vesical artery. Then nerve supply of the ureter is by the autonomic nervous system. Then next is the function of the ureter. So your main function of the ureter is carries urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder by the peristalsis movement, which is the wave-like movement which allows the urine to flow from the upper to the lower into the bladder. Then rhythmic contraction of the smooth muscle present in the muscularis, which allows the rhythmic contraction. And pressure from the full bladder compress the ureter and prevents the backflow. So oblique passage of the ureter into the urinary bladder. So when there is a fullness of the bladder, about 500 to 600 ml of the urine accumulated into the bladder, at that time the urine bladder will be distended and it will compress the ureter and it will close the opening of the ureter, which prevents the backflow of the urine into the ureters. So this is about the function of the ureter. Thank you.